So students, let's start with the next section now. This section contains three questions. The answers to these three questions are double-digit integers. So let's start with question number 38. Consider the following adsorption isotherms for the amount of adsorption versus the pressure. So we've been given five graphs. So we have to identify the curves which are showing adsorption in multimolecular layer. So if the total number of curves as per the question is P, then we have to report the value of 3P. So students, if you look at the curves given to us, we can see that the first curve represents monolayer adsorption. Whereas, if you look at the curves 2, 3, 4 and 5, we can see that the examiner has given us curves for multilayer adsorption. So 2, 3, 4 and 5 represent multilayer adsorption in which after the adsorption of a single layer, there can be further adsorption as the molecules can adsorb other molecules onto themselves with the help of van der Waals forces, which accounts for the increase in the amount of the adsorbate on increasing of pressure, as opposed to the monolayered one in which it will just go and saturate up to a point. So students, the value of P here is equal to 4. And since the examiner has asked us about the value of 3P, so 3P will be equal to 12. And we have to mark the answer of this question as 12. Let us look at the next question. Question number 39. When the following salts are heated strongly, assume that complete salt is decomposed into the products and no part of the salt remains as residue. So we have been given four salts. If one mole of each salt is heated, then X moles of paramagnetic gases will be produced. Then the value of 4X is. So students, if you look at these compounds and consider their heating. So we have ammonium dichromate. So NH4 whole twice Cr2O7 upon heating. So it forms N2, it forms Cr2O3 and it forms H2O. So out of these given species, the N2O and the H2O might be gases at high temperatures, but the examiner is interested only in the paramagnetic gases. So none of the gases present here are paramagnetic. So we don't have to consider this reaction at all. If we look at the next salt, ammonium perchlorate. So NH4 ClO4. So this on heating, it forms N2, it forms Cl2, it forms O2, and it forms H2O. If we try and balance this equation, we have half N2, we'll have half Cl2, we'll have 2H2O, and we'll have one mole of O2. So if you look at the gases produced here, N2 is diamagnetic, Cl2 is also diamagnetic, O2 is paramagnetic, yes, and H2O is also diamagnetic. So we have one mole of ammonium perchlorate heated. So this will lead to formation of one mole of O2. Let us look at the next compound. The next compound given to us is NH4IO4. So this will behave in a similar manner as NH4ClO4. It will give us half N2, will give us half I2, will give us one mole of O2, and it is going to give us 2 mole of H2. So again, another 1 mole of a paramagnetic gas is produced here, as all of these species had 1 mole each. Looking at the last species, which is lithium nitrate. So LiNO3, when it is subjected to heating, it decomposes to form Li2O plus NO2 plus O2. So if we try and balance this reaction, we'll have half Li2O, we'll have 1 NO2, and we're going to have 1/4 O2. Now, if we try and figure out the moles of paramagnetic gases that are produced here, so we have NO2, which is also paramagnetic gas, and we have O2, which is also paramagnetic gas. So, 1 mole of lithium nitrate is going to form 1 mole of NO2 and 0.25 moles of O2. So, students, the examiner is interested in knowing about the moles of paramagnetic gas that are produced. So, students, we can see that the value of X will be equal to 3.25, and since the examiner is interested in the value of 4x, the value of 4x can be simplified to 13. So students, we have to mark the answer to this question as 13. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 40. The sample A participates in the transformations given in scheme. Only the products that contain A are shown in the scheme. Other side products are not shown. 1, 2, 3, etc. are the numbers assigned to a particular strip. So we have the different reagents and the steps associated with each conversion. So it is given to us that A is a group 16 element, which is a solid and insoluble in water. The B is a water soluble gas, and substances E and F are water soluble solids. So in nth step, step number already given in scheme, a gas X is produced which can turn acidified permanganate solution to colorless. Suppose the gas X is evolved in more than one step, then add all the numbers assigned to this step. So students, we can see that the element A given to us is sulfur. So when sulfur is allowed to undergo combustion, it forms SO2. Now, conversion of SO2 to SO3 requires a catalyst. So the species C is going to be SO3. Now, when SO3 is allowed to react with water, it forms H2SO4. So the species D is H2SO4. And when it is allowed to react with KOH, it will undergo an acid-base reaction with KOH, leading to the formation of K2SO4. And when the K2SO4, concentrated solution of K2SO4, is subjected to electrolysis, we're going to have the formation of K2S2OH, peroxydisulfate anion. So we can now look at the conversion of B to G now. SO2. SO2 is bubbled through KOH. So when SO2 is bubbled through water, it forms H2SO3. And H2SO3 along with KOH can form K2SO3. So the species G is K2SO3. Now this K2SO3 is allowed to react with A. So A was sulfur, which was present initially. So K2SO3, when it reacts with S or sulfur, it forms K2S2O3, potassium thiosulfate. So which is our compound H. Now this compound H is allowed to react with D. So D was H2SO4. So when K2S2O3 is allowed to react with H2SO4. So the sulfur is regenerated back, as we can see. So A is formed, which was sulfur. It is also going to generate K2SO4, which was the compound E. And the compound B is also generated. So the compound B is SO2. So we already had this A, B and E present in the set of equations. So the examiner is interested in knowing about a gas X which can turn acidified permanganate solution to colorless. So students, among all of these species, there are two gases present. So the gases are SO2 and SO3. And out of these two gases, only SO2 is a reducing agent and it can turn acidified permanganate solution to colorless. In SO3, the sulfur is already in a maximum oxidation state. So it cannot be further oxidized. So it cannot act as a reducing agent. So the compound which we are looking for, the gas X mentioned to us in the question, it is SO2 and it is getting produced in the first reaction and the eighth reaction. So we have 1 plus 8, which is equal to 9. So we have to mark the answer to this question as 09. So this is it for today, guys. I hope the solutions are clear to you.